Hello friends, today we are going to see what is suspension and what are the rules related with suspension in Central Civil Services Classification Control and Appeal Rules 1965. It's very important for departmental examinations. This suspension is very important. It's a very important portion. Actually, rule number 10 of Central Civil Services Classification Control and Appeal Rules 1965 is deals with the term suspension. There are certain sub rules are there. Let us see. This is the portion suspension. Rule number 10. This is rule number 10. Rule number 10 of Central Civil Services Classification Control and Appeal Rules 1965 deals with the suspension. This is sub rule number 1 of rule number 10 of Central Civil Services Classification Control and Appeal Rules 1965. This sub rule number 1 of rule number 10 of CCS CCA Rules 1965 says that the appointing authority or any authority to which it is subordinate, or the disciplinary authority, or any other authority empowered in the behalf by the president by general or special order may be place a government servant under suspension. First of all, we have to kept in mind one thing is that suspension, it is not a punishment. It is just bringing that official away from duty. That is the meaning of term suspension. So here the appointing authority of an official or any authority to which it is subordinate, or the disciplinary authority or any other authority empowered in that behalf by the president by general or special order may be placed a government servant under suspension. This is the here it is says who can place an official under suspension. Here sub clause A of clause 1 of rule number 10 says that where a disciplinary proceedings against him is contemplated or is pending. This is the first reason. Where a disciplinary proceedings against him is contemplated or is pending, or where in the opinion of the authority aforesaid means here, he has engaged himself in activities prejudicial to the interest of the security of state. This is the reason number 2. Sub clause AA of clause 1 of rule number 10 of CCS CCA rules 1965. This is the second reason. Or here it is, there is a third reason. Where a case against him in respect of any criminal offense is under investigation, inquiry or trial. This is the sub clause B of clause 1 of rule number 10 of CCS CCA rules 1965 says where a case against him in respect of any criminal offense is under investigation, inquiry or trial, provided that except in case of an order of suspension made by the Comptroller and a Auditor General in regard to a member of Indian Audit and Account Service, and in regard to an Assistant Accountant General or equivalent other than regular member of IA and AS, where the order of suspension is made by an authority lower than the appointing authority, such authority shall be forthwith report to the appointing authority the circumstances in which the order was made. Even if that suspension order was made by an authority other than the appointing authority, then he should report the reasons for making such an order to the appointing authority concerned, and the appointing authority concerned should have to ratify the order of lower authority, okay, whom the order was actually made. This is the rule number 2 of sub rule number 2 of Rule 10 of CCS CCA rules. A government servant shall be deemed to have been placed under suspension by an order of appointing authority. That means shall be deemed to have been placed under suspension. Why? What are the reasons to for which an official is considered or deemed to have been placed under suspension? These are the reasons. Subrule A of subclause number A of subrule number 2 of rule 10 of CCS CCA rules 1965 says about it. With effect from the date of his detention, if he is detained in custody, whether on a criminal charge or otherwise, for a period exceeding 48 hours. This is the first reason. Second reason, with effect from the date of his conviction. This is the period from which the suspension is deemed with the effect from the date of his conviction. If in the event of a conviction for an offense, he is sentenced to a term of imprisonment exceeding 48 hours and is not forthwith dismissed or removed or compulsory retired consequent to such conviction. There is an explanation for this subrule B. The period of 48 hours referred to in clause B of this subrule shall be computed from the commencement of the imprisonment after conviction, and for this purpose, intermittent periods of imprisonment, if any, shall be taken into account. This is also to be considered. Okay. Then there is rule number 3 of subrule number 3 of rule number 10 of CCCC rules 1965 says where a penalty of dismissal, removal or compulsory retirement from service imposed upon a government servant under suspension is set aside in appeal or on review under these rules, and the case is remitted for further enquiry or action or with any other directions, the order of his suspension shall be deemed to have continued in force on and from the date of the original order of dismissal, removal or compulsory retirement, and shall be remain in force until further orders. That means if an official was removed, dismissed or compulsory retired, to be compulsory retired from service, after the official has submitting an appeal to the appellate authority or reviewing officer, he reviewed the case and set aside the orders of the disciplinary authority with a direction to re-enquire the case. In such cases, the orders made by the disciplinary authority will become null and void, and the official will should have to be under continuous suspension from the order date of order of such removal bar dismissal or compulsory retirement. This is what actually meant in rule number 3 of subrule number 3 of rule number 10 of CCS CCA rules. Okay. Then subrule number 4, where a penalty of dismissal, removal or compulsory retirement from service imposed upon a government servant is set aside or declared or rendered void in consequence of or by a decision of a court of law and the disciplinary authority, on a consideration of the circumstances of the case, decides to hold a further inquiry against him on the allegations on which the penalty of dismissal, removal or compulsory return was originally imposed, the government servant shall be deemed to have been placed under suspension by the appointing authority from the date of original order of dismissal, removal or compulsory retirement, and shall continue to remain under suspension until further orders. This is the same. Actually, in subrule number 4, it says that if that order was issued by that orders of the disciplinary authority was set aside by an appellate authority or a reviewing officer, here the same says about a court of law, meaning is same, but here the official doing the taking the action is different. Here the appellate or reviewing officer, here the court of law. Okay. Then there is a condition for this sub rule number 4, provided that no such further inquiry shall be ordered unless it is intended to meet the situation where the court has passed an order purely on the technical grounds without going into the merit of the case. Okay, this is the condition. Then sub rule number 5 of rule 10 of CCS CCA rules, subject to the provisions contained in sub rule 7 of any order of suspension made or deemed to have been made under this rule shall continue to remain in force until it is modified or revoked by the authority competent to do so. You can understand what actually meant it. Okay. Then sub rule B, clause B of sub rule 5 of rule 10 says that where a government servant is suspended or deemed to have been suspended, whether in connection with the disciplinary proceedings or otherwise, and any other disciplinary proceedings is commenced against him during the continuance of that suspension, the authority competent to place him under suspension may, for reasons to be recorded by him in writing, direct that the government servant shall continue to be under suspension under the termination of all or any of such proceedings. This rule says that any person can again place it under suspension if he is under continuous suspension. Okay. Then clause number C of sub rule number 5 of rule 10 of CCCC rule says that an order of suspension made or deemed to have been made under this rules may at any time be modified or revoked by the authority which made or deemed to have been made the order or by any authority to which that authority is subordinate. The person issued the suspension order or any officer to whom which the officer is subordinate can revoke or modify the suspension order. Okay. Then the sub rule number 6 of rule 10 of CCCC rules says that an order of suspension made or deemed to have been made under this rule shall be reviewed by the authority which is competent to modify or revoke the suspension before the expiry of 90 days from the effective date of suspension on the recommendations of review committee constituted for the purpose and pass orders either extending or revoking the suspension. Subsequent review shall be made before expiry of the extended period of suspension. Extension of suspension shall not be for a period of exceeding 180 days at a time. Okay, this is the sub rule 6 of rule number 10 of CCSCC rules 1965 says. Then sub rule 7 of rule number 10 of CCSCC rules says that an order of suspension made or deemed to have been made under sub rule number 1 or 2 of this rule shall not be valid after a period of 90 days unless it is extended after a review for further period before the expiry of 90 days. That means after the order of first suspension, validity of first suspension order is for 90 days only. After that, the review committee should have to review the case and either extend or revoke that suspension. If that is not revoked or reviewed, the competent authority, then there will not be any validity for that suspension order after 90 days. This is sub rule number 7 of rule number 10 of CCA CCA rules 1965 says. There is a condition provided that no such review of suspension shall be necessary in the case of deemed suspension under sub rule 2 of if the government servant continues to be under suspension at the time of completion of 90 days of suspension and the 90 days period in such cases will count from the date of government servant detained in custody is released from detention or the date on which the fact of his release from detention is intimated to his appointing authority, whichever is later. Okay. This is actually suspension. The important things which you have to keep in mind is the rule number 10 is dealing with the Rule number 10 of Central Civil Services Classification Control and Appeal Rule 1965 deals with the term suspension and all procedure and conditions for placing an official under suspension is available in different sub rules of rule number 10 of CCS CCA rules 1965. Thank you for watching this video. If you liked this video, please don't forget to subscribe this channel and share, like this video and share this to maximum your friends. Thank you.